Oh, thank you very much.
We have August here.
Hello there. How's everyone?
We have Andy here. Andy, I can call you now, right?
Yes, yes. You may call me.
Everybody has
Andy
different names. Now, let me get the three of you right. Am I going to try and guess it, or am I going to get it right? I have to think about this. This is Adriana.
Right.
Yeah.
No, that's okay. Don't tell them.
This is Adriana. This is Taryn, and this is Cho. That's I knew it really. I just wanted. To, I purposely make mistakes. So, do you want to come in the middle? And then
no.
Yeah, you have to come in the middle because I mean I stand too often in the middle.
No, don't do that.
I think I mean one of the obvious. I can't show them. I'll show them another time. Yours are nice as well. Mine's around the back, but I'll show you where I got these later. I mean, if you swap the coat for them, okay?
You got it, bro.
I think maybe we should begin by talking about the fact that, I mean, this is the front line of the band, but the back line is everybody is important. And Eddie Magix has been out here telling me that I have to mention his name in every other sentence. That's what he said. He said you might react like that.
No, he's not with us anymore.
He left about 10 minutes ago.
Do us a favor, don't mention his name.
Your German sounds different than the other guys.
It's English German. That's why.
It's great German.
Ich sollte vielleicht auch erklären, ich habe schon eben erzählt, dass Eddie Magix, der Percussion bei der Gruppe spielt, mir gesagt hat, mir gebeten hat sogar, seinen Namen so oft wie möglich zu sagen. Ich habe ihn dann gefragt, wie wichtig die anderen sind, und er hat mir eben erzählt, dass der Eddie eigentlich jetzt ausgestiegen ist, so vor ungefähr 10 Minuten, nicht mehr ein Mitglied der Gruppe ist. Das stimmt natürlich überhaupt nicht, aber ich bin daran gewöhnt, dass es so ist. The mythology, if that's not too long a word for me to use at this time of the night, of the band, I mean, there is the concept of Kid Creole itself implies that the whole thing is a show that it's not autobiographical, but there are autobiographical elements in it, obviously. Ski Instructor being one example of that.
Yeah, there are some definite autobiographical incidents, but we like to think the whole thing is a legend.
I mean, do you see yourself when you're on stage as being the person you are off stage, or is it a role that's put on purely for when you go on stage?
Role-playing, to be sure. Role-playing. But we all enjoy it so much that it sort of overpowers us and it becomes more important than the actual lives we lead.
Ich habe ihn gefragt, also Kid Creole, das ist ganz klar, das ist eine Figur, die selbst erfunden hat. Ich habe ihn gefragt, ob diese Rolle immer auf der Bühne spielt. Roughly, yeah, roughly this is what he said. Ob diese Rolle auf der Bühne spielt. Und hat mir erzählt, da sind autobiografische Elemente dabei. Aber im Grunde, wenn auf der Bühne geht, dann ist der Kid Creole, das ist was ganz anderes, als was im Grunde im normalen Leben ist. Is that, well, I mean, you can tell him if this is all right. Okay. You should really be doing the translations, because I mean, you do it better than me. But I mean, Albrecht wanted to ask you something anyway, so he's German, I think.
Yeah, auf der Fresh Fruit ist ein großes Geheimnis, nämlich da taucht plötzlich ein Lied auf mit dem Titel Schweinerei. Schweinerei. Ja. Yeah. Und ich habe mir immer gedacht, wie kommt das schöne deutsche Wort Schweinerei auf so eine Platte mit so einer schönen Musik? Ja. Wie passiert es nach New York? Und das Geheimnis ist natürlich leicht gelüftet.
Ja, wenn du so willst. Da ist ja eine Geschichte hinter diesem Album, nicht? Und der August hat gesagt, na, ich will das auf Deutsch schreiben. Und da hat mir die Geschichte erklärt und da habe ich gedacht, na, Schweinerei. Und da hat mir auch die Melodie so vorgehabt, da hat gesagt, na, so soll das so und so tönen, nicht? Und da bin ich mit dem Wort Schweinerei aufgekommen, hat er gesagt, ach, das tönt ganz gut, was heißt denn das? Und da habe ich es ihm erklärt und hat er gefunden, das sei perfekt für das Lied. Nicht?
Das kann ich mir vorstellen.
Yeah. Maybe I should now try and translate that back in English. It's very complicated, like so many different languages. Various people watching in Switzerland have obviously understood that probably better than I did, but basically what Adriana was saying was that she came up with the title Schweinerei herself. Explain it. Well, let me make it up a little bit. I mean, I'm trying to get out of this and help her. She didn't make it up, but she told him what it meant anyway. And what else did you say? I've forgotten now, you see. Do you want to tell me what you said in English? You translate it.
That's hard work.
I needed a song in the story, you see, that summed up the way the kid was feeling at that moment. He was searching for this girl, and the trip had taken him all around the world. He was a bit disconcerted and crestfallen because he hadn't found the girl yet. So I needed a song that would sort of sum up the feeling of the kid at this moment, you know, feeling sort of wanting not to continue. So I asked Adriana, is there a word in the German language that sort of sums up how a guy would feel when he's at his bottom, rock bottom, you know? And I said I wanted to connote something nasty and something that was offensive. And so she came up with the word Schweinerei, which I felt was perfect for the tune.
Do you want to translate that for me?
That's
God, help me out.
That's right, what he said.
He can tell you what Schweinerei means.
Every word he said is right.
Thank you.
Wendy?
Yeah.
You explain it a little
Should
bit.
Should I really say it in English?
Yeah. No, say it in German.
Oh, Schweinerei.
I mean, basically what he
said. What he said, translate what he said again.
Yeah, in the German.
Can you do it, baby?
No.
Because he explained it differently.
There's 11 other songs in that album.
Well, it's just two different interpretations, you see. It's basically the same thing.
Let's forget about that. Let's talk about something else.
It's a great song.
I mean, I can imagine that. I mean, apart from the musical side, but that there's influences from all over the place outside of music. I can imagine the show itself being turned into a film, the story at least.
Yes.
Have you got plans along those lines?
We have many plans to do that. I think that the first step would be to take it to a Broadway stage first, which we're in the works process of doing that right now with the help of Mr. Joseph Papp, under the aegis of Joseph Papp. That might become a reality in the spring of 1983. After that, we hope that's a stepping stone toward the cinema. After we have success on Broadway, hopefully, we can transfer that success, transmogrify it into a cinematic work. Can you translate
that? I shan't translate that last word, but I'll translate the rest of it. Ich habe ihn eigentlich gefragt, ich habe ihm vorher gesagt, es ist ganz klar, es gibt eine Menge Einflüsse bei seiner Musik, die nicht nur von der Musik herkommen, sondern auch, man kann sich sehr gut vorstellen, dass man einen Film machen könnte aus diese Musik. Und er hat gesagt, eigentlich hat die Gruppe ungefähr sowas vor. I'm gonna get the end of this stuff. Die Gruppe hat das ungefähr vor. Zuerst aber will er ein Theaterstück draus machen. Das soll auf Broadway laufen. Der Impresario.
Yes, Impresario.
Joseph Papp.
Yes,
ja,
yes.
Ist ein Mann in New York, der sich dafür interessiert. Und der August hofft, dass diese Möglichkeit wahrnehmen kann. Und das nach diesem Theaterstück wird dann ein Film gemacht. If a film was to be made out of it, I mean, if you considered someone to direct it, I mean, would you direct it yourself or can you imagine anybody else?
That's a good question, actually. I would, there are not many directors that I respect that are alive today. Many of them, unfortunately, have died off. I would think I'd give a try at directing it. I'd give a try at directing it with the help of someone who was more experienced, of course. Yeah.
Ich habe ihn auch gefragt, ob, wenn ein Film daraus entstanden sollte, wer die Regie machen sollte, ob er das selbst machen würde oder konnte. Und er hat gesagt, eigentlich hat er jetzt Interesse, sowas zu machen. Er würde auf jeden Fall versuchen. Andy, I saw you. You were talking about blackmail earlier. I saw you in Cologne about 3 months ago. Let me ask
the lights, the heavy lights. Oh.
Yeah. I saw you in Cologne about 3 months ago when you jammed after a concert with Nico. Ooh. The band, I think, were in Cologne for about a whole week.
Right.
Is that something that you'll normally do? No, away from these people, the rest of you will get up and jam?
We never ever do it. Ever do it.
Matter of fact, I didn't
know
anything about this.
No. Good thing. Oh, he wasn't supposed to know. Yeah. But no, we were in the place, and by popular demand, the crowd kept saying, come on, you gotta play, you gotta play. So I got treated to some orange juice, got a few marks, and we went up there. Got paid really nice, 5 marks.
You got paid 5 marks for this?
Yes.
I hope you'll deduct that from the wages for tonight.
No, in fact, that was a lot of fun, because we never get to do that, because in Kid Creole, everything is planned out, and we never jam. Everything is thought of, beat by beat, image by image. And for the first time, we all cut loose. It's sort of like being let out of the nut house.
Right. Finally, we got somebody else on TV that moans as well.
Yeah.
Ich habe ihn eigentlich erzählt, ich habe ihn und ein paar andere Musiker von der Gruppe vor ungefähr 3 Monaten in Köln gesehen. Die haben da ein Konzert von Nico in Köln gespielt. Und er meinte, diese Möglichkeit haben die nicht sehr oft, weil alles bei Kid Creole sehr geplant ist. Jede Note ist geplant. Diese Freiheit hat man da nicht, so zu spielen, wie die damals gespielt haben. Ich glaube, es gibt sowieso ab und zu so Ego-Probleme, aber irgendwie nicht, oder? I mean, there are ego problems amongst the band.
Das ist gut.
I mean, your,
das ist gut.
Your picture does appear rather often on stage, on placards and posters as well.
Nein, nur süß sein lassen.
Süß sein
lassen. You're just going to translate that.
Okay, ask the girl some questions, because
yeah,
we don't
want to
look
questions.
Very chauvinistic, just me and
all. So I'll stand in front of you, then you don't need to.
Oh, well,
let me ask you about the costumes and then the dance routines. Who's responsible for the costumes and for the dance routines?
Adriana.
I'll take responsibility for that.
Costumes. Costumes, I think we all sit together and design them and then bring it to a tailor and have him make them up, such as these. And, choreography, I'm responsible for.
Die Kostüme, werden eigentlich von Adriana an die anderen auch vorgeschlagen, die werden dann so gemacht. Die ganze Choreografie, auch schwer auf Deutsch zu sagen, schwer genug auf Englisch zu sagen, das macht Adriana. I mean, I was dancing when you were soundchecking the other day too, so I think we should maybe...
That's why you're sweating.
That's why I'm sweating now. It's taken 3 days, but it's finally gotten to me. So I think we should maybe stop so that I can go and dance and have a real reason for sweating instead of standing here under all these lights sweating. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Okay,
you're
thank
welcome.
You.
You're welcome.
You can go now. You can go now and perform in about 20 minutes.
Thank you so much.
Sorry about all this sweat. I'll dry it off in a minute.
Thank you.
Ich habe auch eben eigentlich erzählt, ich habe bei den Soundchecks ziemlich viel getanzt. Deswegen haben wir jetzt dieses Interview unterbrochen. Ich habe Lust zu tanzen und einen richtigen Grund zu haben, zu schwitzen. Also es reicht mir nicht, unter diese Lampen zu stehen.
Gibt es nachher sicher?
Hoffentlich, ja.
Es gibt noch einen kleinen Nachtrag, nämlich Kid Creole sind auf Tour. Auch in Deutschland. Und sie sind jetzt gerade in England auf Tour, spielen da. Und vielleicht ein kleiner Ausschnitt aus dem Rock'n'Roll-Leben oder aus dem Leben der Gruppe Kid Creole. Sie sind nämlich gestern Morgen auf dem Düsseldorfer Flughafen angekommen, nachdem sie die Nacht vorher noch in Leicester gespielt haben, in England. Sie sind mit einer Sondermaschine mit Samt-Equipment angekommen, hatten die Nacht über nicht geschlafen. Einzelne Mitglieder der Gruppe haben dann schon auf dem Gepäckband gelegen, um sich etwas auszuruhen, jede Minute auszunutzen, wo sie sich ausruhen können. Sie sind dann ins Hotel gefahren, gestern Morgen, haben etwas geschlafen, geruht und haben dann um 6 Uhr abends mit den Proben hier angefangen und haben uns, es sind so 100 Leute hier vielleicht in der Halle, in der Grubehalle, eine wahnsinnig schöne Probe hingelegt und haben richtig heiß und gut gearbeitet bis um 11. Und heute Abend spielen sie hier für uns, ja, jetzt wahrscheinlich ab 2 oder so. Und morgen Abend werden sie wieder in Innsbruck spielen. Also sie fahren morgen früh, fliegen morgen früh wieder zurück. Ja. Also so sieht es ungefähr aus, wenn man hier, wenn man bei Kid Creole and the Coconuts arbeitet.
I'll just translate.
Oh ja.
They work very hard.
Yes.
name is Eddie Magic, and I'm here to welcome your boy. This is the USS Banana Boat, baby, and we're coming right at you. Oh! I'd like to let you know we're going to be making all the regular stops this evening. The fabulous Manhood Island. Kunta couldn't take it, Reef. Yeah. And of course, everyone's favorite, B. Dilly Bay. So just sit right back, because this is the safest crew in the world. Is that right? Because just like you know, and I know, it ain't nothing but a lifeboat party. Come on, get your hands together right here. Come on!
Got to have a party tonight. 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 Got to have a party tonight.
Thank you. story of poor old Prince Haley. He's a wonderful thing. Annie, he's not your daddy. And he damn sure is corrupt. Guys and dolls, would you please meet and greet? Thank you.
Monique. I want to talk to you, I want to show you my little black book. You see this? Yeah. I want to talk about my A's, all right? Can I talk about my A's? I'm going to talk about my A's. No brag, just facts. I got Anna. I got Amy. I got Anita. I got Andrea.
You got who?
Andrea. You don't know her, baby. I'm not through with my A's, buddy, all right? I got more A's. I got Addie, dear Addie. I got Amanda Blue. I got Ada Rodriguez. I got Sophie. I got Anita.
I ain't letting you get away with that. Sophie? I thought you were talking about the A's. Now where you got Sophie from, huh?
Hold it, buddy. I said I got a Sophie. My B's are better than my A's. I got Bonnie. I got Belinda. I got Perfecta. I got Bora Bora. I got Barbara. I got another Barbara. And another Barbara. Here I got a...
Talk a lot about A's and B's, Kid Creole. But I got the real scoop on you. I heard you were a something.
Hold it.
I'm no softie. it, please. Doris, you can take my Burger King. Doris, even take my ring ding. But don't take my coconuts. Don't take my coconuts. Don't take my coconuts. Don't take my coconuts. Doris, you can take my Italian ice. Doris, you can take my shrimp fried rice. Doris, you can take my baby Ruth. Doris, even take my sweet tooth. But don't take my coconuts. Don't take my coconuts. Don't take my coconuts. Don't take my coconuts.
Oh! is made of ignorance and child believing. Had mama left and not confessed, perhaps I'd love you too. Yes, I'm telling it to you straight, so you don't have to hear it no more.
Break it to me.
Anybody out there from New York City? Well, I guess I should say, hello, Germany. The Gates, as they say over here. It's good to be here. We love New York City, but every once in a while it's good to get away, you know what I mean? The boys in the band, Mr. Peter Schott on keyboard. Mr. Mark Mazur on guitar. Miss Carol Coleman on the bass. Mr. Al Mack on the drum. We call him Bongo Eddie on percussion. The professor, Lee Robertson, on trombone. On saxophone, clarinet, flutes, and other things, Mr. Charles Lagan. Hitman, Ken Fradley, on the trumpet. And of course, everybody's favorite, the Coconut. My right-hand man, Mr. Sugar-Coated Andy Hernandez. And of course,
course, you know who this guy is, right? Kid Creole.
Thank you.
Kid Creole.
We'd like to change the pace here a bit. Do something from my latest LP, a thing entitled No Fish Today.
I'm sorry, man. Thank you. You think you can find me somebody?
I think so, yeah.
If you can find me somebody, I'll tell you what. I'll give you 25 Deutschmark. You can find me one person out there. Tell me what I'm talking about.
You know, kid, I'll bet you all the money in the world, but I have no Deutschmarks on me. No money. My hat. You take my hat. You know, I believe that there is somebody that knows what you're talking about. I bet my hat. Is there somebody out there that knows what the kid's talking about? There's gotta be one person, please, that's my favorite hat. I'm gonna find somebody. Magic, help me out.
I ain't talking about no food. About no food. Here I was talking about all the food.
Oh, what's your name, big fella?
My name is Jacob Oppenheimer. Jacob. Jacob!
Yeah.
I ain't talking about no food.
Yes, dear, you are talking about the food.
You talk about it.
Yes. Tell the people what the kid's talking about.
Well, he was talking about all the food, but he was eating it. I think so. This is what I doubt without have done a doubt about it.
Hold on, hold on. You're close. You're close. Kid, kid, tell him. Give him a hit, kid.
There's a lot of things in life you can eat that ain't food, buddy. Well.
It's my favorite hat. Come on, Jacob.
You are not missing. I'm sure you are.
Okay, one more. Come on. Just tell him what the kid's talking about. Tell the people out there.
I think he was talking about the food which is he was. For a long time, he didn't eat anything, I think so. That's why he was on.
In case you want to know.
I've lost more than I've gained. Bewildered and ashamed, I let her slip away. At least I get to keep the memory.
He's back, no one's you please meet and greet the bravest women I have ever known, the coconut!
Snowballing you.
like so, didn't you? Tell me about it. Come on.
Gina, Gina.
What can you do for you that I couldn't do? Cutting up. Instead of dressing up,
Imitation, huh, brother? Imitation, huh? Wait a minute. I got news for you, babe. Say, buddy. Imitation, huh? Wait a minute. Thank you.
Everybody,
Ich fand es schön, dass ihr da wart, dass ihr zugeguckt habt. Ich hoffe, es hat euch ein bisschen Spaß gemacht. Ich verabschiede mich bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss dann. Ja?